Tlaloc, the rain god of Aztec culture and mythology, a figure who's been venerated for many, many years by this culture. He, of course, comes to us from the pantheon and culture of the Aztec people, is a male energy deity who was associated with the rain itself, and that became his alias, the Rainmaker. He is not only associated with rain, but also lightning, an indicator of great power, as we've talked about in other deities that we've looked at, that when you see an association with lightning, that this is typically the head of the pantheon, the most powerful of them. And his weapon was a staff, which was the symbol of lightning. And very much like Zeus or Indra, we see that same association with the power of lightning held in their hands. As a Aztec rain god, his dwelling was said to be partially in the cloud-capped mountains, but also he was partial to springs and lakes and caves, as he often concealed himself behind dark storm clouds. He was portrayed in many tellings as having a black body with a painted face. As I had mentioned, he carries his very powerful staff, which is the symbol of lightning and his power and authority, and that may either have teeth or possibly snakes entwined around it. Again, a massive show of power and status. But he was a very kind deity as well, and that is probably what he is most known for. It is said that those who were drowned or died after being struck by lightning or became afflicted with leprosy were always admitted into the kingdom of Tlaloc, where they would never again suffer. And he was always venerated as being a very kind and beneficent giver of life and a sustenance, so he fed his people as well. He was at times feared, but because of his ability to control the weather, sending hail, thunder, and lightning, and this was a reflection of him being, you know, an incredibly powerful element of water, which was his true association. He is also associated with caves, springs, and mountains, and most specifically the sacred mountain where it is said he himself was believed to reside. His animal form includes the bird herons, as far as also water-dwelling creatures such as amphibian snails and sea creatures, and probably shellfish. This is a deity who has been venerated by this culture and people since the earliest times of their culture, and though there was not much written mythology, we understand the importance of this deity to those people and what he represented, being the beneficent protector who brought rain and thus fertility and life. And through studying these deifications and venerations, we can possibly learn more about the people and their connection to other parts of the world. Thank you again for stopping at Nine World Chronicle. As always, we ask that you like and subscribe.